eight myths proposed by Professor Keith Holtz. And then finally, I'm going to give you some strategies to be used in your classes. Here in my, you know, in my virtual classroom, you can see that I have, I mean, your flag, our flag, and also the book that we will be using today. So welcome to my class, and this is the virtual class. Remember that I also want to make sure that if you want to have your virtual classroom, just talk to Joel and we can plan maybe something in the future so everybody can create their very own virtual classroom. It's quite easy. So count on me on Let's as well to create your virtual classroom. So remember, tip number one, let's begin our classes with an agenda. It's just to focus on what we're going to do today. So it was my agenda. And let's go on with the presentation we're gonna have today. Basically, I have two main objectives for you. Number one is to explore one out of the eight vocabulary myths proposed by Professor Keith Holtz. And second, I'm going to provide you with some vocabulary learning strategies that are called VLS and examples to be used in your very own context. Please take into account, bear in mind that what is my goal? My goal is that everything we're gonna use today is possible to be developed and carried out, not only on, I mean, paper, but also PowerPoints, but also online, and also, I mean, the idea is that all the activities that I'm gonna show you today, if you say, no, you know, Mauro, my students, they don't have internet connection. Okay, I say, okay, this is the option that I'm gonna give you. Oh, you know, teacher or Mauro? Yeah, they have online. Okay, this is the thing you can do. So all the activities are going to be developed in all kinds of formats. This is one of my goals. Okay, after having the objectives, let's go on with this picture that I want to share with you. Okay, this picture says, oh guys, are you too busy to improve? This is my question. You say, and you can say, yeah, okay, I mean, now I've been using the same strategies, I have no time to change or to improve. Or, I mean, now what we're going to do, I say, okay, look, if somebody nowadays, we have lots of things in our heads, but if somebody says, okay, look, this is a tool, this is a strategy that I have for you, let's give it a try and see how useful it is. And we can try it and see, maybe we can change, or maybe that person or that website is trying to make our lives easier. So don't say no. Maybe that is what I'm also going to do today, is like share with you some strategies and see how they can make your life a little bit easier nowadays. Let's go on. All right, I want to start with this important concept in our ELT life field, communicative competence. It's not our fault that many people, even some teachers, colleagues, we think that communicative competence is only speaking, but not. Communicative competence involves many, many things that we teach every day. The CC, or communicative competence, is divided into linguistic, strategic, sociolinguistic, and discourse competence. Why I'm talking about that? Because next time that you like teach vocabulary, you teach idioms, you teach transition words, don't think that you're doing something bad. No, because you can prove that these kind of topics or strategies are included in the communicative competence. So that is why I kind of have, I want to highlight here in the linguistic competence, we have vocabulary. That means that if it is included in the communicative competence, is because it's important. So next time that somebody says, oh, you know, why are you spending too much time teaching vocabulary? You can say, okay, sorry, but based on the communicative competence, I have to do that. So just to let you know why, and to let you know, even grammar, you can see grammar there in the linguistic competence. Now, Professor Keith Holtz says that a way to look vocabulary for ESL and linguistic learners is through single words, set phrases, phrasal verbs, and idioms. I mean, learning a word means that we need to learn many, many things that are involved. when we talk about single words, and when we say, okay, guys, today we're going to learn the months of the year, days of the week, we are familiar with that. Now, set phrases, we need to teach them. When you say, oh, okay, the bottom line is da 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 da, but we don't say the lowest line. No, it's a set phrase that we need to accept it. Don't think, okay, no, what is not the highest line? What is isn't the lowest? No, no, just accept it. And this is the way we're going to teach. Phrase or verbs. Oh, gosh, this is one of the most, like, let's say, toughest things to teach in English, but I just want to mention that. And idioms. When you say feeling under the weather, when we say, you know, Mauro, the English in Colombia, the English from Panama is not useful in the States. I mean, it's not that it's not useful, but is that because sometimes we lack knowledge of idioms. So today I'm gonna give you some strategies because we don't have enough time to review single words and idioms. Let's go on with the book that we're going to use today. This is a book that is called Dictionary Myths. Why I'm talking about the book? Why? Because if you're going to use one of the strategies that I'm gonna share with you today, you are going to be safe. Why? Because all of them are based on research. So if you have a principal, a coordinator, or even a colleague, they say, ah, you know, Stephanie, why are you using that? You say, oh, I got it. It's not because I want to do it, but I'm doing that based on some research. So this is one thing we need to have when we implement many things in our classes. For sure, the things that we do, and I do, are based on research. But the thing that we need to know, what is the right book or the source where we get the info. Okay, Professor Ford said that there are basically 8 myths when it comes to learning and teaching vocabulary. I'm not going to explain each one in details because we're going to focus only on number 6. But I want to share with you what are they all about. Number 1. People say, in learning another language, vocabulary is not as important as grammar. So this is a myth. That means that vocabulary could be even the same, you never know, even more important than grammar, but it's no less important. This is vocabulary myth number one. Number 2, using wordlets to learn vocabulary is unproductive. You say, oh, why are you teaching just the least of the months of the year, the least of animals? Okay, I don't want to say that it's an unproductive. It's productive as long as you select the right words. And you have to stop and reflect, okay, why I'm teaching these kind of animals? Are these animals found in Panama, in Colombia, in the States? So that means that when you teach a list of items, make sure that those items are going to be used and found everywhere, in videos or everyday conversations. It's not just teaching animals, like 100 animals. It's better to teach 10 that you're sure that they're gonna be used. Now, present number 3. Presenting vocabulary in semantic sets facilitates learning. Yeah, you can say, let's go into learn things that you can do on weekends. Another set could be objects that are used in the house. Yeah, you can teach that, but it's better to integrate those like objects, but are not isolated. Number 4, this is the use of translations to learn new vocab should be discouraged. No. I mean, when we have words like teacher, case kidney, you know, kidney. Okay, guys, riñón, kidney, that's fine. I mean, you're not going to translate every single word, but there are some words that gonna take time and it's gonna be kind of difficult to explain. So this myth says, okay, don't worry, you can translate some words into Spanish. It's not bad. Don't feel bad because, oh, I translated kidney. I said, guys, it was riñón. I say, oh, you know, it's eggplant, and I say berenjena. Don't feel guilty about it because it's possible to use some Spanish in classes. Now, let's go on. Number 4, guessing words from context is an excellent strategy for learning vocabulary. I don't know, when you have a reading and you have a word that you don't know, I don't know, I'm not sure about the rest of the word. They say you're gonna learn it by the context, but a professor says, you need to be careful about it. Now, number 6 is the one we're going to focus on today. The best vocabulary learners make use of 1 or 2 years, you say, no, you know, I learned vocabulary only with one strategy. No, no, no. There is a myth, because it's no magical strategy to learn. You have to use lots. This is what we're going to see today. Number 7, the best dictionary for language learners is a monolingual dictionary. We can also use a bilingual dictionary. It's not Mauricio who is saying that. It's not Joel. It's not Let's. Based on research, that they say that we can use bilingual dictionaries in classes. Now, number 8, teachers, textbooks, and curricula cover language vocabulary adequately. Okay, why I say no? Okay, why this is a myth? You know that when we teach English, always unit 7, chapter 7 is about, or 8 is about getting sick. So you say, yeah, it's getting sick. But before that chapter, as Professor Ford says, nobody gets sick. So when you say, hello, class number 1, basic. Hello, how are you? Oh, good, I'm fine, thank you, new. But nobody in the book says, oh, I have a headache. No, because you have to wait until chapter 7 to get sick in English. I don't know why. And then after chapter 7, nobody gets sick anymore. Everybody's still happy. So that is why we say that textbooks sometimes doesn't cover, like they don't cover a vocabulary like in a good way. Okay, this is a big picture that I want to give you about vocabulary myths that we're going to explore later. But now, number 6. Okay, what is the strategy we're going to do today? I'm gonna give you the example, myth number 6. And then I'm going to show you some examples about how can we prove or how can we practice this myth. They say the best vocab learners make use of only 1 or 2 the effective specific BLS, vocabulary learning strategy. No, I'm going to show you, or we're going to show you that it's not only 1 or 2. That could be more than 1 or 2. And that those activities that we're going to have now are to show that. So there is not a magical way or a strategy to learn vocabulary. We know that. And also, you know, some strategies also depend on the needs of the students, of the personality even. If I say, you know, I'm not a person who likes to learn things for memory because I feel bad. So if you don't want to learn by memory, if you feel bad, so don't do it because you feel that your personality is going to be affected. Maybe, maybe. Or the needs. Okay, I'm going to take TOEFL IBT. I need to learn academic works for my TOEFL IBT or for my IELTS. So that is why I'm also saying that it all depends on the needs and personalities. Now, let's get started with the part that I like the most, activities. Now, I have an activity that is called the odd one. So everybody's going to get ready because Joel is going to read the answers that you're going to provide. Always tip number 3 or 4. Always provide students with examples. Always, because otherwise, everybody's going to be confused. Example, this is the old one. So we have eel, squid, raccoon, and octopus. Then I'm gonna show the pictures. Oh, before that, you have to say, what is the different one? Odd means different. Say, eel, squid, raccoon, octopus. Students are going to say, oh, there is no right or wrong answer. Students are gonna say, oh, teacher, maybe it's eel. Why? How come? Somebody says, oh, it's raccoon. Why? Because raccoon is not a sea animal, because raccoon lives, I don't know. So this is an example. Words and then provide the pictures. We're going to have the exercise now. Remember, this activity can be done on paper, online, PowerPoint, games, every format that you can imagine. Let's begin now with our exercise. Joel, ready for the answer? Brazil, right, Germany.
Let me see.
We are ready. Paraguay and Jordan. Please, right. What is the different one?
Please write on the chat box your answers and then I can read it.
Brazil, German, Paraguay, and Jordan. What is different?
William says Jordan, Sarah says Jordan. Feel free to write in the chat box.
This is the idea.
You can read it.
Guys, look, another thing. When you are teaching, you can use this slide for 5 seconds, 5 minutes, 50 minutes. I mean, you can explore one slide. It's up to you. And a slide can be the just 5 seconds, 10 seconds, or 1 minute, or even an hour. So I have this. The answer is German, because German is not a country. German is a language, you know?
Okay.
So, Mauricio, but why are you in the picture? I say, yeah, I am in the picture because I was in Jordan. In Colombia, we say, chicaneando. No. I mean, you know, because this is a way that my students are going, Wasnik, oh, teacher, when were you in Jordan? Why? So, if it is a conversation club, an activity, students can ask the teacher, if I was there, was good, because, oh, teacher, tell us more about that, because I saw that castle or that thing in Indiana Jones 3. So this is a way that a place, if you have been ever, if you have been to the States, or even in Panama, in different provinces, use the pictures, you are in the big team. Why? Because the students can ask you questions about that. Please bear this in mind. Next. Okay, I have kiwi, cabbage, cauliflower, and beet. Before that, you can, don't show the picture, but I'm going to do it now, because now you know what we are doing now. But after that, you show the pictures, teacher, it was kiwi, because the others are vegetables, and you can explore.
Okay.
If you are teaching, teacher, Mauro, I have to teach like, or present perfect, you know, the grammar. We have to teach grammar anytime, every time. Now, what we have to do is, do you like, let's going to use like, do you like kiwi? Does your mom like cabbage? And then you can say, oh, Mauro, but I have to use have you ever. Oh, have you ever eaten beet? Have you ever? Oh, it was in past. Oh, did you eat? So you can use this for every single grammar tense you imagine. We have more. Okay, more. We have more. I'm going to go quickly because we have more things to do. But I just to give you an idea. Mathematics. Oh, teacher, but this is not math class. The students complain. Hey guys, no, calm down, because you need to learn math, geography, science, everything through English. English is not only verb to be and adverb adjectives. No, English is also math, geography, many things. Okay, this is right, because right, no, rhombus. Rhombus is not a triangle. Okay, I love this, because this way you personalize your classes. If I ask you, hey, how many provinces does Panama have? You say, oh, Mauro, I have no idea. But, you know, this is the way that you can practice and also your students. I have La Palma, Los Santos, Herrera, Chiriquí. What is different?
La Palma.
Yeah, La Palma. Then you say, why?
La Palma, yeah. La Palma stage is
La Palma.
La Palma, Itza, La Palma, Sara, La Palma.
La Palma is the different.
Exactly, which La Palma is the capital of Darien, but Los Santos, Chiriquí, Herrera are provinces. And then I can ask, who has been to Los Santos? Who has been to Chiriquí? I mean, you know, you can explore or describe the picture. I mean, what is that term? Okay, next. More. Okay, oh, this. Jesse, Forky, Simba, and Slinky. Teacher, what is that? I say, what is that? This is the answer. You have kids, you have children. We need to get updated about what children like. So, Toy Story 4. Even if you don't like, you have to like it, because that kids are gonna be so happy. Oh, you know, you say, Mauro, but you know, I'm teaching description. Oh, this is perfect. Can you please describe Jesse? Oh, Jesse has is wearing this. Forky is a fork with red hands, and so on. So, and the students are gonna be happy because these are maybe their favorite characters. More, I have more, but I just, it was the idea. Oh, this one, El Ingenio, Villalucre, El Dorado, Cinco de Mayo. Ah, tricky. Tomorrow, I have no idea.
Wait if they check in the chat box.
Even let's Joel, I don't think Joel knows the answer. Joel, you don't know it, right?
Okay, no. What is different? El Dorado, Sofia says El Dorado. All right. Stacy said, okay, Stacy doesn't know, he's not from Panama. Villalucre is different.
Anyway, yeah. But if you don't know Panama, the answer is El Dorado, because El Dorado is not a metro station. So Ingenio Villalucre Cinco de Mayo. So you can say, teacher, for me it's Cinco de Mayo because I have no friends in that area. I mean, it's an example. It's an example. Anyways, so. And also you can learn about Colombia because you are neighbors and maybe you come to Colombia, you want to learn more about Colombia. So this is another one. Coco, Cartagena, Casanare, Cesar. What is the answer? The answer is, I'm going to give you that, is Cartagena, because Cartagena is a city, but Chocó, that is your neighbor from Panama, and Casanare and Cesar, they are departments, what we call departments. So, this was the activity number one that I want to share with you. And now, what I'm going to do is, you say, Mauricio, but I'm, you know, my students, they don't have internet connection, because, you know, we know there are many things going on. What you can do is also design this activity on a piece of paper out of your learning guides, guía de aprendizaje. So you can have here a handout, and just it's the same activity. It's not like as beautiful as the other one because it doesn't have pictures. But what I want to let you know is maybe encourage you is that everything is possible, both technologically and both paper. This is an example. So you can add this to your students' learning guides, like a warm-up. Plus, if you say, you know, let me see, if you say, Mauro, but you know, in my school, we need to prove that we are using technology. Okay, you say, in your report, principal, this is the answer. This activity can also be planned or completed on Google Docs. So look, if you want to have this activity on Google Docs, you can also do it with pictures, without pictures, like everything you can imagine in a Google Doc. But it's the same activity with the same purpose, to let a student see whether they like this strategy. And that is myth number six. There is not only one strategy, there are more strategies. So some students say, oh, I prefer number this because I don't like pictures. Some students say that. Or they say, oh, I love number two because, you know, it's pink and, you know, it has beautiful pictures. So maybe it happens. Or some, okay, just to let you know that you can do this. Even there are five versions of the old one, number five. And then this activity. So remember, paper, PowerPoint, and Google Docs. This was activity number one. And let's go on with more strategies. And this is the second strategy that, okay, remember that I told you before that we're gonna work on also on idioms. Oh, idioms are a headache for us to learn. Now, I want to let you know that all languages have idioms that we say here in Spanish, maybe me costó un ojo a la cara, mariposas en el estómago, the same in English. But an idiom, sometimes they aren't transparent. That means when they aren't transparent, that means that the meaning doesn't make any sense to us. We have here, this is an example that we have, and we say, what is the meaning of let the cat out of the bag? Oh, the professor says, I mean, there is no cat, there is no bag, there is no cat in the bag. It's like in our imagination. But the meaning is like, just tell somebody a secret. I mean, it's like, I was told a secret and I just tell everybody that secret. This is please, or something like they say, don't let the cat out of the bag. It's an example of an idiom. And okay, but I'm gonna give you a strategy that is suggested by Holmes 2014, how we can teach. Okay, you are my student, and I say, guys, I'm gonna give you a strategy. Let's see if you say, I like it or I don't like it. So it's up to you. But hopefully, if you like it, you're going to practice that strategy more constantly, because otherwise, you're not going to keep your rhythm to learn vocabulary. He says, number one, make a note of the idiom. So you just take a note, let the couch out of the bag, under the weather. Then what we're going to do is, number two, define and explain it understandable words. Okay, we say, under the weather. Okay, under the weather means to be sick. Ah, it's an easy synonym. And number three, give at least two or three sample sentences to illustrate the meaning. We have an example here, bark up the wrong tree and until cows come home. Now, how are you going to apply this strategy? Look, this is the example. You write the idiom on the website, there in the slide, or a piece of paper. Then you have a picture, and then you have the meaning. And finally, write sentences. How did mom find out we were planning a surprise party for her? Oh my goodness. Who let the cat out of the bag? Who? Next, when Margarita decided she was going to quit her job, she told her best friend not to let the cat out of the bag. As you can see, this is a strategy. We're going to promote it in our classes. Why? Because in that way, not only our students are going to improve their vocabulary, but also we are going to do it. Go ahead. Apple of one's eye. So the same strategy. The word, then we're going to have the picture, the synonym, and finally the sentences. So this was a strategy that also help us to support that myth number six, that is not only one or two strategies to learn vocabulary. I'm going to share with you this link. This is a link that I have. I created this link for you to review some websites that you can use to review vocabulary. Let me share that right now with you. And what you can do there, go there, is check. You can check the some websites that you can use for, okay, let me, I'm gonna undo it now. Okay, yeah, you get the link. This is an extra activity that you can, or let's say just an extra resource that your students are going to have. This resource, okay, I'm going to explain what is this all about. In this resource, what we're going to find is like the three steps for learning idioms. And here, when you click here, you are going to have an extra link in which you are going to review different idioms, like for kids, idiom of the week. And here you have some PDF books about idioms. And then you have like a PowerPoint presentation illustrating how I'm going to teach with the title, the picture, and some sentences. So this is for you to review. Let's go on. Okay. When teaching vocabulary, what we have to do is train students to teach themselves. Because why? Because in class, we're going to teach only, a small percentage of the words that students need. So when we teach this, okay, don't say, okay, guys, we're gonna learn idioms. And you just show the slide and have a student read the sentence. No, you have to explain, okay, there are three steps to review, to learn idioms that I suggest. Okay, number one, number two, number three. In that case, students are learning the strategy. Even though they say, no, Mauro, but they are not going to be teachers. I know, but in that way, you are sharing a strategy and they are going to teach themselves later with other kind of topics. Now, I have this, another activity that I have for you is this, that maybe students also are going to use to improve their vocabulary. I have a template for you that you can use. This is the template. And what is the activity all about? It doesn't matter the level, because sometimes we can use this with basic levels to practice shapes. Okay, rectangle, also to practice colors. Okay, tell me, what are the colors of Panamanian flag, Panama flag, or Belgian flag, or Uruguay flag? So here is an example. In this case, what the students have to do, they are going to select the flag. Which flag is that? Argentina, Uruguay, or Paraguay? So they say, oh, teacher, I don't know, but maybe they have to do some research, or some students know. So this is one thing about flags. Another, maybe I told you before, cartoons, because we can have these activities not only for adults, teenagers, but also for little kids. So one activity can be completed or can be developed or implemented for many different levels. So please try to avoid saying, no, I can't use that activity for my little kids. I can't do it with my adults. No, you can. Yes, you can do it. Now here, actions. In actions, you say, no, because Mauro, I have a really advanced level. So when you have a really advanced level, you can also implement it with some, let's say, idioms. So more and more activities. Now, if you say, oh, Mauro, but I know I want my students to play. I like this activity, but it's paper-based. You know, I want to do it, but I'm more like with more technology or with more games interactive, because, you know, kids or teenagers, they have cell phones. But one thing is that they don't like to use their cell phones to learn English, to study English. We know that. We need to be, I mean, it's something that we need to accept. They don't like it, but maybe they like to play some games. That is why we're going to give them some options. What do you mean? I mean, what I mean is like, you're gonna see this game that is a game with the having the flags as like the main activity. Look at this game, it's quite easy to play. It's easy, but students might like it. This is the game, and we're going to do it. Okay, the game is about the flags. Look, the same flags that I had on my piece of paper are the same flags that I'm going to use to design my exercise. So here, Uruguay, yes. So it's also a way students can use to check their activities in case they can have access to it. Skip, we go on. Another one, number two. Chile, Panama, Costa Rica. Let's make a mistake. Chile. Wrong. Anyways, but I wanted to show you. Now let's see number three. We can keep this an addictive because you can, what you want to keep playing and playing. India, Nepal, Pakistan. Tricky. Yeah, but it's India. So this is another way that I remember from paper to PowerPoint to more interactive activities with these games. I like these games because it's a way that you can use to provide students with more interactive activities. And you know, good news, what we are doing now is basing our activities on one book. I mean, not only this book, could be any book, but if they say, oh, you know, professor, okay, say, Jason, why are you using this game in class? Or why are you using this flag activity? You know, señor coordinador, señor ministro, you know why? It's because based on theory, I mean, I need to provide my students not only with one or two vocabulary strategies. It's my job, my commitment to provide them with lots of activities. In that way, some students say, teacher, this game was extremely boring. I prefer to use the paper. That's fine. Maybe another one is gonna say, teacher, I love those games. Okay, this is the way that we are proving maybe some different learning styles, or we say before, the needs of students or even the personality of our students. Okay, in that case, going on with the myth number six, students, the idea that if the students like those games, why don't we provide students with more games? Why? Because in that way, they're going to have that strategy practice every day and with more, they're gonna be more consistently with this strategy. I mean, they're gonna be practicing their vocabulary more constant. And also what we have to do is hopefully our learners, they're gonna, I mean, the idea that when you say, okay, in this rest of the semester, I'm going to provide students with 10 strategies. So you're gonna say, I did a good job. Let's see which one is gonna be the favorite for some of them. Or they say, teacher, I like all of them or only one or two, but you are doing a good job because you are providing, or we are providing students with more strategies. Okay, now, I like this activity. Why? Because for this activity, I want to show you like a strategy that I use in my classes to teach these words. Okay, when I say, guys, you know, we're doing a game, how do you say manguera? Some students say, teacher, manger. No, it's not manger, no. Look, how do you say nariz in English? I tell my students, how do you say nariz? Teacher, nose. Okay, now, knows. You, let's change the first letter. Instead of N, let's gonna have an H. And now you have manguera. Ah, so maybe for some students, it is a strategy that is going to work out. Maybe, maybe. Okay, then, teach guys, how do you say carpa when you go camping? Ah, teacher, no idea. Some students say carp. No, I said, no, 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 it's not carp. No, it's not. How do you say número 10? 10. So let's add a letter T at the end. N, 10 is 10, y 10 es carpa. Mm, so, and now, niños, guys, how do you say nido? Mm, teacher, no idea. Okay, remember, there is a famous brand, cookies and the Milo, and you know, the name is Nestlé. What is the logo of Nestlé? Ah, teacher, es un nidito. Ah, okay. So from that nido, nest is nest, es nido. The pro Nestlé is nido. So this is a look. In this way, we are like the book and the professor also suggests. Okay, let's gonna use the words, the letters, the pronunciation, maybe the logos. And now in our classes, the students, oh, today, just in 1 minute, I learned 3 new words. So our vocab is improving in every class. Host, tent, and nest. Another activity. Okay, nobody knows what valley is. Okay, we don't know what is that. Let's see this strategy. It's a conversation. Oh, teacher say, can someone pronounce this word? Yes, teacher, valley. What is the first letter of the word? Oh, teacher, is V. V, okay. Make the connection between V and a valley. Then the teacher, what the teacher does is go to the board and draw a V. All right, next, like 2 lines, because we have in mind, we plan that students are going to understand the word valley, like mountains, right? So it's a valley, something between mountains. And now it happens that in Medellin, we live in Aburrá Valley, Valle de Aburrá. So I can show the picture, like, okay, guys, look, this is a valley. Okay, this is an strategy that maybe can work. So my students are, oh, teacher, no, I didn't find this interesting, but maybe some students are gonna say, oh, teacher, for now, I mean, valley is a new word that I won't forget because I live in Valle de Aburrá and I'm always going to remind the letter V as valley. So this is another way that you can, and what we are doing now is having strategies. And one thing that I want to tell you, it's not only strategies for our students, it's also for us, because we teachers, we also need to keep working on our vocabulary. So these strategies can be useful. And when we teach or when we select words to teach in our classes, if we don't know the words, please use them. Why? Because this is the way that we are going also, because we can use apple, banana, apple, but when we have peach, maybe when we have grapefruit, if we don't know the meaning of those words, that's fine, because in that way we're going also to improve our very own vocabulary. Okay, Mr. Joel, how are we with time? Professor Joel.
We're gonna stay here for 3 days with you because we know that we're gonna learn a lot. But still we have 10 more minutes to finish the presentation, and then we have 10 more minutes for questions and answers. If you have any question, please.
Oh, no, no, but it's such a good news, bro, Joel. Yeah, thank you.
I have more 10 minutes here on Zoom, and then I can read it, and Mauricio could answer your questions.
Okay, yeah, 10 minutes, I promise that I'm gonna finish, bro. Okay, now let's go on with this. Myth number 6. Okay, I told you before, create links with the letter V, maybe pronunciation that is not that easy, and form of the word. Sometimes we say, okay, what is the meaning of review? Review, you can divide it into 2. Re, do it again, and view, etc. So this is an example. But now, I want to give you an extra super tip. Mauro, why are you excited about it? Why? Because now that we are in our houses in Panama, in Colombia, we need to take advantage of everything we have to teach with Realia. Because when COVID-19 is disappeared, I don't know, hopefully soon, we are going back to our schools, but we are not going to have the objects that now we have in class to take to the school. So now, why don't we use the words in the kitchen, living room, bedrooms to improve or to promote student vocabulary? When you pay a lot of money for an immersion program in Canada, the United States, oh yes, I'm going to United States, I'm going to Canada, that's okay. When you go there, you say, okay, I want to learn everything. How do you say mantel? How do you say in the States, in Canada? But why don't we take advantage now that everybody's at home and promote activities to improve our daily objects, daily life objects? Example, I'm gonna give you some tips. Now, realize the use of everyday objects in the class. We know that. Okay, when we're going to teach, let's say that today our topic is fruits. I'm gonna give you four strategies: spelling, scrambled words, pictures, and realia. And remember, when we are attending these kind of workshops or a class, we're gonna say, Mauricio, I like number one, I don't like number three, but at least you are being reflective on that. Okay, let's see with number one, spelling. I tell guys, everybody, we can do it now. Everybody on a piece of paper, you are going to write down five numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Why? Because you're going to listen to five words that are gonna be spelled from the audio, and you're going to write down those fruits, five fruits. So let's get started with number one. Number one is this. Oh no, we're gonna listen to the five words. Listen to them. Sorry. Listen.
Let me see. One.
A. P. P. L. E.
Two.
Two.
G. R. A. N. A. D. I. L. L. A.
Three.
Three.
G. R. A. P. E. S.
Four. Two words. Two.
Four.
P. A. S. S. I. O. N. F.
F.
R. U. I. T.
Five.
Five.
S. A. P. O. T. E.
Mr. Joel, any answers on the chat?
All right, please text your answers on the chat box. I can read them. Let's see.
Number one, the most common.
Who wants to write number one on the chat box? Apple.
Yes.
Was Apple number one?
Yes, yes, you yes. Was, yes. Number two. I don't know if you have that fruit. It's
Granadilla.
Granadilla. Do you have that fruit in Panama? Yes. Granadilla?
Yes.
Or maybe it has another name. We never know.
Passion fruit, zapote.
Yeah, zapote. Zapote sounds like. Okay, now, this one. Number one, spelling. Go ahead. Another activity, a way you can have students review vocabulary as a warm up. Another strategy is like. Scrambled words. Number one, you know. No, it's not campus word, it's fruit. Okay, this is, you know, apple. Then, the same, I mean, just to let you know there is another way to do it. Please, and one tip, tip number 20. When you have students complete scrambled words, always leave the first letter and the last letter at their places. Please don't mix everything. The first letter is there and the last letter is in the right place. Just mix the things inside. Otherwise, students are going to be confused, and sometimes we too. Number, okay, we go grapes, you know, fruit. Okay, do us scrambled words. Activity number three, we have listening, spelling, scrambled words. Now we have pictures. Apple, granadilla, apples, granadilla, grapes, passion fruit. Okay, now number four is the one that I like the most. Mauro, why? Because we can use, now that we are at home, we can use real fruits. It's not, guys, imagine that I have an apple on my hand. No, it's not imagine. I have an apple on my hand. Okay, I have granadilla. And then we can take advantage and this and say, for example, Juan, describe the granadilla. Oh, you know, teacher, the granadilla is large, is big, is small. In that way, we are practicing the famous or the most difficult type English, like adjective noun. This is a structure that is quite tough. So in this way, we are promoting that. I have grapes, I have passion fruit, and I have zapote. So that is why I'm saying that we can use realia, because when we are back to schools, I don't think we're going to take a bag full of fruits to school. Maybe yes, but it's not that easy sometimes. So it was realia. And I have another, remember that there are five ways that we can teach this topic. They don't say way, they're gonna say strategies. This strategy, remember, we have some students who say, oh, teacher, I love the game we played yesterday with the flags. Please, teacher, another one. You say, okay. Let's gonna do it. And let's gonna play another one, but with fruit. Realia. So this is the one of realia. Look, this one. So we have here, no, let me see, no, there is the link. The link is this. There is the link, and we're going to do it now. Let me start again. It's another game, but with fruit, the five fruits that we are reviewing today. Remember? Start now. Here, we have to select. Okay, grapes. Yes, teacher, I learned it. Next, we have apple. Made a mistake. No. Okay, we go on, and this is a way that our students are completing and also interactive activity. So now, with these activities, what is happening is that we tend to complain, and students also, because sometimes they don't like some strategies. But in this case, we are offering five options. Okay, guys, we're going to learn by listening, or we're going to learn by scrambled words. We're going to have a strategy that is with pictures, or we're going to have a strategy with real objects, or six, we're going to have a strategy with games. So if the students don't like any of them, I don't know what else can we do, but we are offering five. And now, just to finish this presentation, I want you to read these sentences, and there are your houses, are your places, you wanna say, oh, I can do this. After seeing this, oh, Mauro, sorry, I can do this. You say, no, Mauro, I'm not good at technology because, you know, no. And then, Mauro, I don't understand how you did that. Oh, it doesn't work with my students. Why? Because, you know, I have, like, imagine we have sometimes 400 students, and, you know, they don't have internet connection, they don't have this and this. Anyways, oh, Mauro, this doesn't make sense. I mean, I have been teaching vocabulary, and this is my, okay, I say, no, please don't be so negative, and let's go into change our words with something that is called the power of yet. What is the power of yet? The power of yet is, I can't do this yet. I'm not good at this yet. I don't understand this yet. It didn't work, or it doesn't work yet. Or this doesn't make sense yet. So that is why When we say yet, you say Bauro, but when I'm going to say I can do this or I'm good at this, okay, that is why we are here. I mean, when I say we, could be your colleagues in, I mean, your schools, your principals, Let's Panama, Joel, as Joel, Mauro in Colombia. So that is why we are like now to support each other. Just stop being selfish because, you know, Mauro, I spent a long weekend doing this activity, completing the activity, designing the activity. How come I have to share this with my friends, with my colleagues? No, I know that you're not thinking that way, but in case somebody thinks that way, please stop doing this. And we are now to share and to change that using the power of yet. So that is why we offer our help to you. I don't know how, getting in touch through Let's Panama, through Mauricio directly, but this is the way I wanted to share. I wanted to end or finish this presentation that is hopefully not going to be the last one. So we have more things to share. And Joel, I think I am really.
Let's give
I have a picture of Panama.
A virtual applause, please. Virtual applause.
When I was in Panama on Sundays, I used to go to the causeway by myself, no friends. No, just kidding. I just went.
Right. Thank you very much, Mauricio, for sharing with us these tips and ideas. And there is one question here that it says, it is a good idea to teach vocabulary through picture to seventh graders. Is it a good idea to teach vocabulary through picture to seventh graders?
Okay, yeah. Let me show you an example, and I'm gonna say, what can we do with that? Okay, give me like 30 seconds, and I'm going to show you what we're going to do with that. Yes. Let me see why I'm gonna say yes. Okay, I have an example of, I have several pictures here that I want to show you. I have like a collection of pictures here. So you can see, oh, teacher, I want to have that. Yeah, why not? I can share this with you. And then, Joel, look, the pictures we're going to share. Okay, and you say, I am teaching in seventh grade. Yes, and I love this picture. So I'm not sure about, okay, why? Because Colombia, we have a curriculum for the whole country. So for seventh grade, I know what we have to teach in Cartagena, in Medellin, in Cali, in Pereira. But I'm not saying that, what I'm saying that is because we need to make sure what topics are you teaching in seventh grade. Let's suppose that you are teaching present progressive. Remember, when we use present progressive, we don't tell students simple past, present progressive, no. We just tell maybe something that is happening now, that happened in the past, because the students are not like, they don't need to know this kind of vocabulary that we use in our profession. Okay, now, let's suppose that for seventh grade, your students are learning present progressive. Okay, I can use this picture to say, okay, Juanita, tell me, what is the chef doing? What is the granddad doing? He said, no, Mauro, this is too advanced. Okay, now let's going to go less. Okay, let's going to talk about colors. How much? How much are they? How much pieces of watermelon is the man carrying? Not carrying. Now let's going to use for the seventh grade, for example, description. Imagine your students say, okay, teacher, there are two boys playing. Teacher, ¿cómo se dice tennis? Okay, how do we say that? Okay, tennis. And then they have curly hair and so on. Now, if it's for speaking, you can say, guys, the task for next week is you're gonna have 30 seconds to describe this picture. How? Hello, my name is Sofia, my name is Sebastian, and I'm going to describe the picture. There are 10 people in the picture, two boys and three girls. They are happy. Okay, and look, the sentence that I use are, because sometimes we say, no, but maybe my students don't have that level. No, let's go into use the picture for any level, even from preschool students or for little kids. Guys, tell me, what color is the umbrella? Teacher, pink, yellow. What color is the watermelon? So what I'm saying is that, yes, the answer is yes. Yes, I do encourage you to use pictures. And don't think that a one picture is only for one level. This is multi-level. If you have a student that is really advanced, I mean, just may compare. Guys, this picture maybe, where is the picture taking place? In Panama, in Colombia? I don't think we have this kind of picnics. Maybe yes. So let's compare. Where is this picture taking place? Do we have picnics in Panama, in Colombia, like this picnic? Yes. And they have to give reasons why they say yes or why they say no. Sure.
Thank you, Mauricio. See, here we have some messages like, thank you, Mauricio. You are very kind. Highly appreciated with your strategies. Awesome presentation. Great. Thank you very much. Thank you very much from Sara Valdez. Amazing session. Thank you, Veronica. Thank you so much. I learned something new today. Thanks a lot for your time sharing valuable knowledge. Thanks a lot. Good job. This is great. Travel and tourism vocabulary. Thanks, Mauricio. Thank you. Using picture, wonderful, promoting speaking activities. A lot of thank you things. A lot.
I have to thank you too for
love the materials and everything you share. So thank you. We had more than 40 people connected today in this event. It's been recorded, and I really appreciate if you can go to our YouTube channel and you subscribe, because all our presentations will be uploaded there. And I would like to share about our international conference on October 16 and 17. If you see my background picture, there is let me close my pen here. Here is the conference that we have. It's an international conference. We have people from US, from Philippines, from Colombia, from Panama, from Guatemala, from England. So it's gonna be great. It's gonna be 2 days of activities, and we are going to have that event. The idea is to collect some money to help people that have been affected with this pandemic, right? So regarding to, you can go to the link, and you can check the link is there. The cost is $15, and then you can go there and pay online or do everything online. Regarding to the book that Mauricio mentioned, the book is the company selling Kid Falls book in Panama, the authorized company selling Kid Falls. Kid Falls will be in the conference as well, and then we're gonna have a seminar about this topic, a full seminar that is gonna be 40-hour seminar. Is just about all the myth. We're gonna work on all the myth. And then we invite you to join on our webinar on Friday. It's in Spanish. It's about personal and professional growth, but it's in Spanish as well. We also invite you to check our podcast. Next week is gonna be the launch of our podcast. And you are all invited to follow us on Spotify and listen to our podcast. Again, thank you very much for your time. And for joining today. And Mauricio, I think if you have anything to share, it is your opportunity.
Okay, a couple of things, Joel. Okay, what about if I'm in Colombia and I want to attend that convention or conference in October?
It's very easy. You just go to the link. You just go to the link there and you register. You can pay online, right? You with your credit card, and you will get the link. Everything's gonna be through Zoom.
Wonderful.
Yeah. All is gonna be through Zoom, and I have to tell you that we'll have some performance from people from, I cannot tell you where, but we have international singer that is gonna be performing during the event.
Joel, let's say that I say, okay, Joel, I can go. I mean, on Fridays I work, so I won't be able to attend the conference on Friday, but I'm going to be on Saturday. What happened with the Friday section? Because I'm not going to be there.
The Friday sessions will start in the afternoon. The opening event starts at 1:30 p.m. and ends around 5. And all the sessions will be recorded, right? Then you will receive the link for the session that probably because of any duty you have, those sessions will be recorded and you will receive the sessions.
Okay.
Thank you. You go to YouTube and say Let's Panama, you will find the channel. How do you find it? Okay. Any other questions?
Yeah. Okay, I had a comment. Okay, now that thank you so much for everybody attending this. But I mean, when I say especially Colombian ones, because today is holiday in Colombia, so today we have no classes because in Colombia we have holidays almost every week. Joel knows that.
Yes, so today, the time that I used to travel here on Mondays was days off. I couldn't do anything.
And that is why this neighborhood is quiet. Okay, no, by the way, Joel, I want to tell you something. Tell me what is the way that we can share today's resources with teachers because we or they deserve, because being here an hour and, you know, and I told you before, we are not supposed to be selfish. So just, Joel, let me know how you or Let's is going to share these files, the links, because this is my idea that everybody has these links and resources.
Next, right.
Then what you have to do is see how can you adapt them. But I want you to have these resources. So just Joel is the one in charge of.
They can go to our Facebook page and the video of this event is there. It's been recorded. And you can watch all the presentation and the power and the slides in there. And then you can find the information. And if you want to, you know, you don't have Facebook and you don't follow us on Facebook, you can have the video, you can send us an email at assistentelex@gmail.com. You will receive the whole video of the event.
Okay, and please, we are friends, we are colleagues. If you say, oh, you know, Mauro, you didn't send us the link about this and this, just let me know. So because the idea that you have everything with you, so you can apply them in your classes.
Okay.
Basically, that's it.
Bueno, gracias, parcero. Gracias.
Gracias. Yes, it. Yeah, and Juan de.
Thank you very much for your time. People, open your cameras. Open your cameras and say hi. Open your cameras. Vamos a ver si nos tomamos una fotito. Open your camera.
Hey, you know, it's weird. I feel homesick about not being in Panama today. Yeah. Yes. Anyways.
All right. Thank you very much for your time. Be well.
Bye-bye.
Stay healthy. All right?
Yeah. Bye.
See you next time.
Bye-bye. Thank you. Bye-bye. Say bye.
Thank you, Mauricio.
No, you're welcome, Joel. Bye-bye.
See you.
Sophie, hello, Sarah, bye.
Bye-bye, bye-bye, bye-bye.